think that's the end of the river. It was incredibly wide and all salty and so on. It's got small waves on it from the wind. And it's probably about 100 metres wide with big sand dunes on the other side. Have a look at this. That's some very solid estuarine landscape right there. You go a long way to beat that. Probably not even the Rhine or the Mekong could beat that. That's solid. Still haven't seen any pelicans. See, I don't know if, I'm not sure if you saw those sticks and everything out there. I think that's oysters, an oyster farm kind of thing. Certainly worth, if you're travelling down here, turning off and going down the Koorong Loop Road. Get a good look at the Koorong on both sides, but especially out the passenger side of the window as you're heading in the direction of Meninji. That's Meninji. So the road did loop around there, and I get the sense where seem to be bearing right now, so I get the sense that we're heading back towards the highway. So it's not far, it's only about a 10 minute, or you'd be able to read it on the timer. We're travelling at about 60 through this loop road. There's only about a 10 minute drive around. Loop road here is quite adequate for a two-wheel drive vehicle. You don't need a special vehicle to travel here. It's beautifully graded, and of course, after rain, you've got some potholes here, but with water in them. But it's nicely looked after, and no problems driving your normal rent-a car from Hertz or Avis or whatever. Wicked camper vans,
juicy.
Along this loop road, coming out of it now, and yeah, it's about a 10 or 15 minute detour, I guess, 10 minutes. Well worthwhile if you're travelling around this area of South Australia. Didn't actually see a pelican on that occasion. We rejoin the highway here at Salt Creek. Sign on the top of the Salt Creek Hotel there says Heart of the Koorong. Some more Koorong action there. Not sure if we've got much coming up here in the next group of kilometres, so might just give you another fast forward opportunity here. And actually, completely wrong about that. Looks like out the left hand side of the window we've got some massive Coorong action. Hopefully these dunes will get out of the way and we can have a look. Turns out there's a bunch of trees, so sun's just gone behind the clouds again. It looks darker on the video than what it really is. It's only 4:27 South Australia time, 4:57 real time in the afternoon. And I think we will go for that fast forward opportunity, so I'll lay off the commentary for the next 5 minutes and give you a bit of wide open road.